sabi ni BP Sara na si Speaker Martin at si Chairman Ko ang nagko-control ng budget, ng national budget. Ito po ba sa palagay nyo, ito po ba ay taktika dahil nabigo siyang idepensa yung 125 confidential fund?
Fake news lang po yun, dito sabi niya. Hindi totoo yun.
Nung bata pa ako, minsan nahuli akong kumakain ng wala sa oras. At sinisi ko, niluto ng maaga, nilagay sa mesa, hindi ko mapigilan ang sarili ko. Diba? It's very easy to point fingers. The issue here is not whether the budget is being controlled by so many people. The budget is being prepared by the executive, deliberated by the legislative. It's a matter of public record, nandyan sa lahat. Now, utilization. Sinasabi niyang kontrolado ng execute ng legislative utilization. Bakit ilang porsyento ba ang sa school building na na-implement? 3% lang. Ang hina naman nung mga nagko-control nun. Pero hindi naman siguro yun ang issue eh. Ang issue talaga dito, accountability. Kung masagot niya sana yon. And obviously with her statements and her interview na release part 3, hindi ko nga alam bakit hindi na sinabay-sabay. So baka bukas may part 4 at sa susunod part 5, talagang dinideflect po niya. Klaro po yun, di ba? Hindi naman yun yung pinag-uusapan niya yun. At she could have made better use of the time by explaining why, saying that in Congress, in front of us congressmen, and not before a television camera. Di ba? Sana dito niya sinabi yun na kinokontrol. Kasi we would have asked, na ma'am, pag kinokontrol ng dalawang tao, bakit 3% lang ang utilization ng school building projects natin?
Precisely why it's called the executive. Sila pa yung nag-i-implement. We're just here to exercise the power of the purse. You know, we're here to lay out the budget once it's submitted to the executive. Sila po mag-implement. So I don't know why there is now that... And actually, to answer the question, parang paglilis nga po. Kasi nga po, that's precisely within your area of jurisdiction. Your authority is to implement. Tapos sinasabi mo po, it is controlled and implemented not only by another branch, but by only two people of that branch. Sobrang, it's far-fetched po. And personally ako, I kind of take that as an offense. Kasi we take pride in our work here in the House. And ako, one of my proudest moments was finding intelligence funds in the MMDA. Ako po nakahanap yan. Ako po nag-request from MMDA. I worked hours on studying their budget. Tapos sasabihin, control lang ng dalawa. And there are many more of me. There were 300 of us here and we all do our part. I see that, our congressmen, I'm very proud of them. We do our part here in the House. And to say that it's only two people that controls it.
Well, the Vice President is second highest official of the land. We may disagree with her, we may feel slighted by her personal actions, but nonetheless, we are duty-bound to uphold the Constitution, and the Constitution accords her that position in our system of governance. I don't see any reason why we should. We may have disagreements with the person, but you know, we are all elected officials of the people, and the Vice President is an elected official of the nation. So, ako, correct. It's an attempt. It's obviously an attempt to divert the issues that would have been properly treated in Congress during the Appropriations Committee hearing. All these claims about the leadership, about confidential funds, it's very disheartening kasi bakit kami pa na gumawa ang tama ng tama para sa taong bayan? Kami na nagginawa yung lahat para maging transparent, kami pa ang i-impute na may ginawang kamalian. Diba? Kongreso na nga ang nag-take ng step to make the confidential funds more transparent. Ngayon, kami pa ang sasabihan na it's an attempt as a form of political attack against the Vice President. I think the representatives of the people have a better use of their time rather than just attending to these matters.
So I think given that, if she had appeared before us yesterday, she would have had the opportunity to talk about the budget in the future, as she claims that she would. But with the interview na lumalabas, parang linilihis po eh. Parang she just refuses to answer questions, whether man it is the CIF or whether it's about the actual budget proposed and used currently. So I think that's my take po on the interview po and the timing of its release. Salamat po.
On my part, this is how I look at it. I'm satisfied because COA is not selective on rendering their decision, especially if it is borne out from their own findings. Now, even nobody really is exempted from the scrutiny of how each agencies of government, regardless whether you're on top or you're the highest, you're not insulated from the COA assessment. By way you utilize the fundings sourced out from the taxpayers' money. So I'm satisfied on that aspect kasi ginagawa ang COA yung kanilang trabaho. Now, similarly, ang trabaho din, mandato kasi ng COA yun under the Constitution, ang mandato rin ng House of Representatives, as explained very well by Kong Jude and Kong Pao and Kong Rog, ay busisiin yung budget na pinopropose bawat taon. Part of that busisiin really is to look at how we can comprehensively appreciate the budget that was given to a certain agency, how they utilize that, supported by the COA reports. Kasi importante po yung utilization, especially if the budget is continuing appropriation. Kasi hindi yung isang mga, in many cases po, ang mga ahensya hindi nila nauubos sa isang taon ng kanilang pondo. Meron pa talaga pong
De, ano, yung sa akin lang naman, karamihan naman kasi ng mga nire-raise niya na parang problema, yung ina-atake daw siya. Karamihan naman ng mga nasabi niya, ina-atake niya yung, parang siya nag-a-atake sa sarili niya. Parang self-inflicted kasi. Pero in the House of Representatives, you have been, from the start, kahit sa press con po, kung may issues man, we stick with the issues. Kung may critique man, after we critique, after we look into the deeper content ng mga sinasabi o ng budget, nag-offer naman kami ng solution. So, issue-based lang po talaga. Kitang-kita naman po yun. Pangatlo, sinasabi niya na ano yun, yung sa pagka-presidente, sorry. Yung mga VP. Oo, siguro familiar sila doon, no? Nung nakarang administrasyon. Hindi naman po attacks kasi yung ginagawa namin. We're focusing on the issues. And susunod nga po, ako po, hindi po ako tatakbong presidente. Ina-announce ko na hindi po ako tatakbong presidente. Nakatutok po kami sa budget. Kaya nga po yung issues circling the Office of the Vice President, which is yung pinakahuli na inattendan po namin na budget hearing. Yung mga tinitignan po natin doon, kung paano i-improve yung Office of the Vice President in terms of budget utilization and the overall budget as well. Salamat po.